Together. Yeah. recently reviewed all the report cards of the boys, and they'll be sent home on Friday. And I know the boys have been working hard, and the teachers have been working hard. And I know you parents, especially this fall and early winter, have been working hard. And I think it's all, vacation comes at a wonderful time. And I know as a parent, I love these vacations because I cherish them to spend time with my children. And I wish you all a very happy and joyful vacation with your kids. They really are treasures.
Got a microphone. graduation story. It's dedicated to my dad, Jeff Sankridge, and my mom, Valerie Rupton. I did not have any clubhouses or ponds, but I did have this yard. In the spring and summer and fall after school, the kids from my building, which was half a dozen kids my age, would come down in the yard. We would invent things. There were a couple of bushes and a staircase, stuff that we made into houses and fortresses and whatnot. Or we would just play tag or hide or hide and seek or basketball or table tennis or hopscotch. We would spend hours there playing what we thought of. It was fun. It was very nice because all the parents would come out on the balcony and supervise us. They did not need to worry about where we were, and they could just let us play there for as long as we wanted to. Eventually, they would start yelling at us to come up, and then we wouldn't want to come up because we were playing, so we would hide and ignore them. Then they would yell some more, and we would ignore them some more, and then they would really yell. My trip was easy. I got on the plane, and the plane flew straight to New York, and I got off the plane. I looked for the bus to take me to Princeton, and I got to Princeton, and I didn't know where to go to get to campus, so I went to the first building that looked like it might be a university building. It ended up being a church, so I got into this basement office in a church and asked them where to go, and they directed me to where I should go. On my trip, I was excited because I was to do finally what I wanted to do for a long time, and what I had worked pretty hard to do, which is to go to the USA to continue my studies. I was also scared and nervous because I was going to an unknown place where I did not know anyone, far away from my friends and family. I was going to be on my own, alone, and I would have to work pretty hard because I was going to a prestigious university with high standards from a small university, and I was worried about being able to meet all their requirements. One of my memories are the people, my friends and family. I also remember the town, the parts of the town I would go through to and from school, especially after school. We would get out of school and then we would all just hang out and walk very slowly across town. Very slowly. We would take 2 hours to go back home because we would drag along and talk and sort of have fun and hang out. Those are really nice memories of long afternoons that we spent going from school home, not really worrying about anything, enjoying ourselves and each other's company. I remember always that Zagreb was a city that was a city but a small manageable city, especially the central part where I lived and the school was. You could walk from one end to another and there would be never too many people. It was never too dangerous or too crowded. It was a pleasant place to be. To write this book, I had to interview my dad, Cheto Sankridge, first and transcribe his words and type them up. After that, I had to edit those same words because if I changed them, it would not be a primary source. After I edited them, I planned and illustrated the book. When I wrote this book, I learned about immigration from my dad.
This book is called The American Immigrant by Teddy. It is dedicated to Angelica. This author's note. This book has been a traditional project of the fourth grade at the Dawson School for many years. This particular book, it's about Angelica, a nice lady who lives in my building. The reason we did this project is that we are learning about primary and secondary sources and immigration. One of the special things about this year is that Hope, a lady from the Tenement Museum, visited our class to teach us about the olden days. And then this is the official certificate of registration for Angelica Ludeman. I was born during World War II. When I grew up in Germany, there were still lots of things left from the World War II, and a lot of rebuilding was going on. The big cities were still being repaired, and there was still rationing going on until the 50s. After that, it was more of or normal like in other countries. I didn't feel in any way anything special was going on at the time. They didn't know what other countries were like. So to me, it was normal until I later found out the history of what had happened. The rationing of rebuilding started right after World War II, in which Germany got a lot of money to rebuild the country. It got completely and totally rebuilt, completely and totally destroyed, and went on through the 50s and 60s. The first night I was in New York, I stayed with friends at Long Island, and then I started looking for an apartment. I rented an apartment on 107th Street on the west side, close to Riverside Park. I had to work, I had work to do, so I had to get organized, I had to get an apartment, and then start working. I went to work on Park Avenue about 54th Street. World, and I wanted to see other countries, so that's why I left Germany. I tried to find ways to visit other countries and study there and work there. I just wanted more than Germany had to offer.
Book to my mom, dad, babysitter who interviewed, the rest of my family, Ms. Wong. I came from Guyana, British Guyana. The government was changing, and there were political changes, gaining independence to a socialist state that many people, including me, did not like. I came to America because it was the place to be. I didn't have any real reason to come here. I just followed everybody. The trip was very good. I had been on a plane before, so it was not unusual. It took 8 hours to get here. I stopped in Trinidad and Barbados. I brought my big suitcase. I thought it was strange when people said, "Why do you bring such a big suitcase? You don't bring such a big suitcase to America." I was treated like an immigrant, except by Jehovah's Witnesses, which is my religion. When I came, I was disappointed. America was not what I thought it would be. I was a babysitter, Harper, and Wyndham were number four. Allison, my babysitter, who has known me since I was born, she's been with me through thick and thin, and I hope that it stays that way. I wrote about her because she tells me about her old country, and I thought it sounded interesting to interview. She's my best babysitter anyone could have, and I love her.
My book is called The Long Journey. This book is dedicated to Christina Stanescu, my immigrant. Survival and spiritual survival. My spirit was threatened too. In order to help my spirit survive, I came here. The plane that I flew in was a 10-hour long flight. My immediate family was left behind, but my brother was already here. I was allowed two suitcases containing my clothes and some scores, as scores of books containing musical sheets. It was November 1990, and I was a little afraid. I am what's called a permanent resident, and I gained that status by being called an alien with extraordinary abilities. I hope in a few years to become a citizen.
Don't do that, William.
Hey, Mom.
No, that's not funny.
Yes, it is. Oh.
Let me hear the song. Let me hear the song.
Thinking that I want to be a duck, so I should cry, but oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Want to be a chicken, I don't want to be a duck.
Go right into church.
Yes. old are you?
10.
Happy birthday. Get to the music, not the intro.
I'm trying if I can figure out where to say your friends.
Fresh air, Ginger! Sam, Bill, or Harry? Did I know?
Well, what do you like to total stranger? Come to my wedding. You might be my dad.
No, Stacy mocked at the invitation. And after reading this diary,
thing with a guitar. I can multiply the guitar into an orchestra. So I didn't know, I didn't have, what's your name again? I played all the bass parts, played all the saxophone parts, and all the drum parts, and all that stuff, and I put it all together. And I put this stuff out, and we had a couple of hit records. That's long before you were born. But all these things that the astronaut are flying around humming and everything, right? They're hits, sure, sure. And what I had was a little box. I don't know, do you have, where is Chris? Is Chris around? Chris, do you have that box? There's a little black box there. It's got some knobs on it. I'd like the people to see that. It's called a Les Pulverizer. And it's with this box. If you've got that, I'd like to show that to these people here. Have you got it, Chris?
It's probably here somewhere, Les.
Yeah, it's in there somewhere.
He's looking for it, Les.
Yes, it's called a Les Pulverizer, and it hooks right onto the back of the guitar here. And when I put that on there, I can change those knobs, and I don't need any of you people. But this is my invention, and do you have it yet, Chris? I'm getting awful nervous up here. You know, I can tell you something in the meantime. When I came to New York, it was in 1937, I played raw. I used to have to play the guitar, and that was it. I hadn't invented all this stuff that I got now. I got so goddamn many things now. Life has taken, you know. I had nothing to do with the streetcar. Someone else invented that. You'd think it was easy. It wasn't easy at all. I worked like hell to get here in this basement.
You want to know something? You're the best. You're the best, baby. You're the best.
Yeah, I know I'm the best. Where are you from? Oh, Brooklyn, big deal.
Where are you from?
Huh? Where am I from? I'm from Waukesha, Wisconsin. So, happy New Year's Eve. Where the hell is that? I thought you'd be interested. This is my first Les Pulverizer. It fits right out here like that. Can you believe that? And we walk out on the stage. I don't know if any of you people are old enough to remember when I invented this thing. And this thing here now, I've advanced this thing with fiber optics. You know we have fiber optics. You know what that is? What do you think? That's something that's playing at Carnegie Hall or something? Fiber you think optics. It's a rock group? Yeah, that's the nosebleeds. You're thinking. Now, the nosebleeds have nothing to do with this. It's my own invention here, the Les Pulverizer. I just wanted you to see this switch right here. Now, did you know that, Lou?
Yes.
You?
Yes.
You did know that?
Yes.
I could take Mary's one voice, and by throwing this switch, I could turn her and make her sing just like Bing Crosby. Right? If I wanted Bing, I'd just, you realize the switches I've thrown in my day? All right, I'm going to set this down now. With the show, okay. Now, you just with that one guitar, what are you gonna do? I would love to have you show off all this stuff that you can do on the guitar. This is one of the finest guitars I've heard in a long, long time. This is it. Frank Vigola, listen to this. He marched in the parade a couple of weeks ago.
Oh,
Would you do our song, Rook?
Well, you remember?
Around the world, I search for you, I travel. What hope has got to keep a rendezvous? Do somewhere, sometimes, somehow. You looked at me and see the smiles you're smiling down. Might have been in County Down or in New York, in Paris. Even London town, no more will I go all around the world. I have found my world in you.
Won't you come home, Bill, baby?
I've searched.
Won't you
for
come home?
I've traveled.
She moaned. She cried all day long.
Keep a rendezvous. I knew.
I'll do
so
the cooking, darling.
Sometimes,
so
you looked at me.
Maybe
I
got you wrong. Who picked this key? Remember that rainy evening? I turned
down or in New York.
Nothing but a
Cape Harry or even
London
town.
Chief, you know
no
I'm
more will
blame,
I go
Louie. Ain't that a shame? Louie, won't you please come on home? Louie and I had this little cabin over in Compton Lakes, New Jersey. We were just as happy as you could get. She was.
She.
He was out playing his guitar. At the clubs, and you were strolling at that time, weren't you? You're still strolling?
I stroll.
All the rest of the week when you're not here with me, you're strolling?
I have found, yes, my world.
Strolling the bar?
Strolling the bar.
Catch anything?
I hope not.
Well, what I was going to say is that, I used to do his laundry for him. I did his cooking when he come home. You remember you come home one night and I had your socks all over the floor and I was sniffing out a pair? Remember that? What the hell are you doing? And then one night did you come home soused. You were a drunkard and a skunk. And you come home and you had this fat old gal with you. She was fat under the arms. She come in with a little damn chihuahua. She sat down on the davenport with a chihuahua humping her leg. Japan, really. Oh, I imagine they got a couple of strange ones over there, too. Yes. Yep. Thank you.
Thank you.
William, base is loaded.
Base is loaded. Who's up?
Dad, can you hold some of
this? All right, Patrick, you're up.
I am. Yeah.
Who's up?
Let's go, buddy. Patrick, get hard.
Patrick's up.
Where's your bat, Patrick?
So, Oxman isn't up? No, no, he's...
Oh, wait, where's Bill?
He was ready to go, but you called the other guy.
Oh, wait a minute, I'm sorry.
Okay, leave him up.
What? All right, he'll go back in. Oxman's supposed to be batting.
William, you're supposed to be batting.
Okay. All right. Oxman, you're up next. Billy, you're up next.
You should have control.
Do you guys have a pen?
Yeah, I do.
You do? You are. So if you don't mind if I grab that for a second.
Okay, William, you're up next, okay?
Okay, Billy Oxman, you're up.
He needs the helmet. Clean, you need that helmet.
Aiden,
you need your helmet.
She's here.
Okay, who's up then, William?
Billy Oxman.
William, want to see, all right? Just watch the ball with that, all right? You get
your shirt in.
William, tuck your shirt in.
Bobby, different ref.
Hold this, right?
This is an expensive pen.
Yes.
I don't want to be responsible.
Okay. Here, I'll take it. Thanks.
Everybody, the only time you touch a bat is when you go to bat. Don't swing any bats at me.
I'm gonna hit in the face last week.
Step back, Sam. Choked up a little bit, William. Let's speed things up. Just change. All right. William. Choked up on that. All right. Up.
You're ready to
let's
roll.
Go, baby.
Up a little bit. Oxman!
Why don't we take our picture out?
Move down a little bit.
Hey, Bill.
Hi, Hayden. It's
the same.
Not really.
They haven't scored yet, right?
Down, get it ready, get it ready, position.
Choke up a little bit, William. Hands up.
Thank you.
Justin didn't bat this.
Let's go, guys.
Nice swing.
Don't swing at the first one. Watch it, Tommy. Don't swing at the first one. Are they too high?
Come in. Good belt high. Sam says I'll hit it. No, I haven't.
Too high, Kate. Tommy. Tom, watch the ball first, Tommy. Let's see what it does. Now they're good. They're good. That's a home run. One strike, right? Okay, Tom, take your time. Nice and easy. Yes. Oh, my God.
That would have been.
Five ball. Double play.
No.
Take your time, Tommy.
No. Right, Tommy. There. Right.
Go, Tommy.
Two
straight, Daniel. Contact.
Right.
Contact.
Okay. Run! 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 Run!
William, you're up.
Okay, William, let's go. Way to go, Tommy!
Basic might be loaded for Jonathan.
Yeah. All right, William Axman, then it's Jonathan.
And then me. That's gonna be fun.
You got one out.
Okay, how are you?
You might get a better view from the other side.
Yeah. Because then you'll see his face, Matty.
Oh, wait.
Ball, William.
There you go. Oh, yeah.
My cat.
Oh, yeah. Hit it.
I don't like one.
Just contact. Just contact the ball.
I like to draw.
Coach, okay.
Come on.
That's it. That's the idea.
I like
draw. Back to the ball.
That's
my favorite. Let's go. Woo. Yeah. Woo. That's the way to do it. Same thing, buddy.
You're connecting, William. That's good.
So, William, same thing. That's two in a row you hit now. That's like batting 1,000. That's all right. You're all right. That's it, William. Look at that. Oh, yeah.
That's a nice stance. I like that.
That's it, William. Come on. Keep doing it.
Good work, William. Good work. You got three balls that you hit. That's good.
All right, Tommy, ready to go.
Okay, how does it feel that you just won your game?
Great.
What do you feel? This is like your last game.
I feel like I have the Fiji flu.
Yeah, okay. But how do you feel that you just played your last game and you're not going to see your team for like another year or so?
Weird.
Feel sad, happy?
No. Just weird. It's like it's not my last game. It's like I'm just beginning a new thing, not ending.
Is that so? Well, how are you really feeling that you just won your game?
I'm proud.
Feel proud of your teammates and yourself?
Yeah.
Do you feel like you just won, like, a World Series or something?
Yeah. Okay, pause.
Go ahead. Very nice, Genevieve.
Can I play one more piece, Dad?
Sure, please do. I'd like to get that. I'd like to hear that. Well, so tell me about your piano playing, Genevieve.
What do you exactly want to know?
Well, whatever you want to tell me. You could tell me what pieces you like playing, what pieces you want to learn next, how you felt yesterday when you were at your recital.
Well, I would like to play some jazz pieces because I really like jazz. Like with Duke Ellington, and he's up and down the keyboard. I like that a lot. And
Well, it was kind of hard to say how I felt in the recital, because I didn't really feel like I was... I wish I never got up in the morning. I wish I wasn't there. I wish there was a trapdoor on the floor that I could just step through and I'd be gone. It's sort of like I wanted to be able to go so I could just get it over with. Hmm. But I liked listening to the other kids, and it didn't feel like I was just like not going to be able to do anything. I was just like going to give out.
You felt like you were going to do well, didn't you?
Yeah.
And you did. Mm-hmm. Did you enjoy performing for other people?
Yeah. I mean, it's nice to make other people feel good. And if they like music, then you got something in common.
Hmm. What are you going to learn next?
What will I learn next? Well, I only got one more class, so I don't really think I'm going to learn, like, a really long song in one day. So I might just, like, you know, play around on his on the teacher's computer, just, like, fool around on the keyboard.
Maybe you should ask him what you should learn while you're at camp this summer.
Maybe I will.
Yes, hello. I'm here.
Turn it off.
Nobody out. First and third.